check it out.
Tough since the incident. Do you still see him?
Yeah.
We need to expand. Open up.
I can't. after meeting with the families of the victims and attending their funerals, it's hard, you know, not having a, you know, resolution. It's, he's still out there.
I see. Sometimes you just gotta move on. Disconnect from anything that reminds us of what happened. Maybe we should take off some time from work.
Can't. The case is still ongoing and he's still out there. Don't want to hurt anyone else.
I understand. But Daniel, you've been fighting this for too long. The chief has asked me to tell you to hand over your badge for a bit and your gun.
Alright.
Intel you requested from the FBI. I have no clue why they're covering this up from the local police. It was your case first.
Yeah, bureaucrats. They actually, they stuck my gun and badge. They're, saying, like, my mental health is not in the right place right now.
Sorry, Daniel, that's... Everybody's just scared right now, I think. Here. Take my gun.
Thank you.
I can get another one tomorrow at work.
Thanks, Jim.
Of course. Now, why here? Come here to get some guidance?
No, it's this cemetery. It's a lot of his victims are buried here.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's okay. Yeah. You just got done into the deep. There was nothing you could do. I get it. But
yeah.
You did your job best you could.
Well, they're trying to push me out of this whole case, so... And you've been here with me since the beginning. Nothing's going to change, but more things are going to have to come through you, okay?
Okay, but let me tell you, the FBI, they're closing this. They're not letting anybody in except for the top execs. I cannot do much anymore. I'll do my best, but I just let you know, it's getting tough.
Well, we'll see what we can do, and Jim, I appreciate it.
Of course.
Thank you.
See you around, Detective.
See you around.
That milk guy again? What's up? What's going on?
There's nothing to be worried about, sir. Please return to your home.
Show yourself. Show yourself.
I know you're seeing him.
How?
Well, in an effort of looking for you, I went to your work and I talked to your therapist, and he said,
I know what he said. What do you want?
So I overheard some high-ranking FBI officials talking.
Yeah?
And they knew a thing or two about this, whole Milkman case. In fact, Tony Bonanno, he died in this exact spot about this time last year. Mob boss, real crazy guy. He actually has a twin brother, Frank Bonanno. And according to them, sounds like he knows a thing or two about this dairy-related product that we're after.
Do you know what this means?
Yeah, it means we finally get a shot at figuring out what the heck is going on with this whole thing.
I finally get that fucking Milkman out of my head.
Yeah.
Let's go to Frank's.
I speak first.
Okay. Yes, sir, and we understand, but we must...
Hey, listen, Blue. Frankly, I don't trust you. I don't trust either of you, okay? As far as I'm concerned, we're on opposite sides.
Listen, Mr. Bonanno, we're not here on typical police business.
Really? Then why is a Fed sitting in my establishment?
Listen. Last year, your brother Tony.
Don't you bring my brother into this.
That Milkman got to him, right? Don't you want to do right by him? He deserves some justice.
I already tried looking for that freak, okay? It doesn't exist. It's a damn phantom, alright? Anything I would tell you, it wouldn't change a thing.
Listen, he's gotten away with too much, Mr. Bonanno.
Alright,
we need more information. We need contacts. Why was your brother there? Why was that place important? You need to tell us something.
He's contracted out by some like foreigners.
What do you mean foreign fellas? Like from where?
Maybe they had some weird accents, like Russia guys, maybe.
It's Russian guys, not Russia guys.
You insulting my intelligence?
Okay. Agent Jim apologizes. He was out of his depth. Can you tell us a little bit more about these Russian folks?
Alright, fine, okay. But after this, I'm not giving you any more information, alright? And then I want you out of my restaurant, alright? So, Tony tells me about some Russian fellas that approach him. They're looking for some milk product. Apparently it's hidden from the world, right? He doesn't know what it means. But they gave him coordinates for it. I guess they didn't want to get their hands dirty. So they contracted out my brother. He goes out,
And next morning, I get a phone call. You know, you know that, you know the story. Basically, they told him it was important for world change, right? And but I mean, that doesn't matter. You know, he was getting paid. Let me tell you, he was getting paid, right? And you know, that's about it. That's all I can tell you.
Well, Mr. Banana, we appreciate your time, and if you have any further concerns, Mr. Jim will leave you with his number, okay? So. Alright.
Oh, pleasure speaking to you, sir.
So what do you think? It's the Russian government? I mean, obviously, somebody's after this milk stuff. I mean, it's got properties I've never seen, never heard of. Somebody's gotta be after it.
Could be the Russians, maybe. I don't know. If it is, that's a huge issue of national security.
Yeah, right. You know, maybe it wouldn't be a bad idea to take this up to the head honchos at my office.
I agree. I think this is a little out of our league.
Okay.
So you're telling me that Russians may be involved in a coup with a crime syndicate plotting to change the world with a secret serum that's hidden around the world?
Well, yes, sir.
Sounds like a load of superstitious hocus-pocus, like something I don't have the time to deal with.
You're grasping at straws here, son.
Well, sir, with all due respect...
Agent Jim, do you have any evidence to support your claim?
No.
And does this lead go anywhere else?
No, sir.
Exactly. You're speaking out of your tongue. And frankly, I should suspend you for running out with this bozo. He's nothing but a complete conspiracy theorist. There is no milkman. There is no Russians. The case is closed. Now get out of my office now!
Yes, sir.
What are we supposed to do now? I mean, not even the authorities are on our side.
Listen, Jim. I appreciate you putting yourself out here, but I don't want you to risk your job. I think we should just lay low for a little bit.
I don't know. What am I supposed to do? Like, there's clearly something going on. There's something here.
It's best we don't involve ourselves too much. Car's right up here.
Oh. See you around, detective.
Yep.
Right, take it easy.
Thank you. Where am I? Where'd you take me? Are you just gonna stare at me? You're gonna kill me like the rest of your victims. Over there? That direction? What's over there?
Hi, I'm Ben Dover at 11156 News. Just the other night here, an FBI agent went missing alongside this road. The FBI is taking over the case, and to tell us more on the topic is the FBI director.
Thank you, Ben. I mean, yeah, we're taking this case very seriously. I mean, it's one of our own this time. So yeah, we have been out here conducting a thorough investigation to make sure we have everything under control.
We heard from an inside source that the agent in question was ready for suspension. Do you believe this has any correlation to do with his disappearance at all?
I don't know where you heard that nonsense from. That has no correlation at all. Just know we have everything under control, everything is fine, and that's all I can speak on the matter.
This has been Bend Over with 11156 News. Thank you.
Where the fuck is Jim?
Who let you in?
I left myself an asshole.
I could have you arrested for trespassing on federal property.
I don't care. Tell me where Jim is.
Listen, Detective Hood, Daniel, can I call you that? We don't know where the fuck Agent Jim is. That's why we're investigating to find out. So how about you shut the fuck up and let me do my goddamn job?
You shut the fuck up.
You have 3 seconds to get out of my office or I'll have the whole building on your ass. No. He thinks that there's something going on, but doesn't know the full picture. His problematic FBI friend is gone.
Your work?
Unfortunately, no. I don't know where he is.
This means the time to reveal ourselves is upon us. The milkman must be back. Things are being set into motion. We will begin phase one of Operation Fiery Horizon. Prep the shipment of formula CMLK.
Yes, sir. We gathered it from the lockers as you requested.
Good. Be seeing you soon.
So where exactly are we?
Israel.
Israel? Israel? I thought we'd be in New Mexico or Utah or something. Not Israel. What exactly are you taking me to see?
not what.
God. What this package contained is chilling enough to make anyone scared. Information was leaked, including the FBI's cover-up of the Milkman case of last year and information on the victims that was never released to the public. The contents include all of the mugshots of the victims. That's right, folks, mugshots. They were all hardened felons who have done many bad things. That begs the question, was the Milkman targeting criminals? It is also reported that the FBI neglected to report on a key motivation of all victims involved, something called
You fool!
Serum
Sir,
Mark
No, sir. Our plan is at risk. The cameras will be exposed.
That,
the
FBI
I promise that won't happen. I won't let it.
You have until sundown to tie loose ends, or else you should consider yourself one of the loose ends. Comrade.
How can we trust the very people who are meant to uphold our laws, if they don't even tell us the truth? We continue this conversation.
Today the people lost something, their sense of freedom. Too long has the government lied and controlled the way we believe. Too long has the American people suffered from a tyrannical government that abuses its power for their own interests. Too long have we accepted the false truths being fed to us. After this groundbreaking report, people begin to see that the Milkman wasn't a villain and wasn't even a vigilante, but a hero. Outing the corruption of the government and the villainous criminals of our nation. We can't trust our government, so we must voice ourselves for change. In the reign of the FBI, let the people choose. Thank you. This has been Bend Over, reporting for 11156 News. Director, 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 director.
Yes, you.
What do you think about the people who feel disenfranchised by the government?
I know you all feel disenfranchised. I understand you are angry. I feel for you. I understand, and I can say with confidence, I was not aware of the situations in the testing going on. It was clearly done under the noses of FBI authorities. With all that being said, we cannot act in this manner, and we have to move on from this matter. We can't be at each other's throats. We're all Americans, and the people responsible will be held accountable. But for now, please stop destroying your own home, your own nation. It will only incite more violence.
Director, sir, are you going to condemn the actions of the Milkman?
Well, of course, it's still murder, no matter if the victim's criminal or not.
What do you have to say about those who are saying that he's doing your job better than you are? Why are you withholding information from us like they're criminals?
Well, Mr. Dover, that thing can't overstep the law, because we are the law, right? And what he did was immoral and wrong. And the reason why we didn't release any of the information about the victims being criminals is because we didn't think it had any relation with the case whatsoever. That is all I can state. No more questions on the matter.
You don't represent us.
I'm telling the truth. The Milkman is a murderer, not a hero. Don't let the media tell you otherwise. The case is closed.
Why do you lie?
I'm not lying.
I'm telling the truth. I'm trying to help you all. Someone give me my business tie. We're heading to Bonanno's.
You idiot! What did you say?
I told him nothing, I swear.
Bullshit! Who was it? Who did you tell?
Hey, B, come on.
You know me. I know you. We're friends, right? I didn't tell anybody, I swear.
You have 3 seconds to fucking tell me who you told this to. God damn it, I swear. 1, 2, 3.
All right, listen. I'll tell you, all right? It was the detective fella, right? And his FBI friend, okay? That's it. That's all I told, I swear. Am I free to go?
Who sent you? The director sent me.
Hey, director. I have your grunt.
What is the status of loose ends?
Almost tied. Moving inbound on the detective now.
Good. And is Bet the agent?
MIA. We'll be too late if he comes back now.
Our plan is moving accordingly. It is almost time for phase 2 of Operation Fire Horizon. Prepare your men. Finish the detective.
Who are you?
I'm the one who knows all. I'm here to give you guidance.
Guidance? What could you possibly share with me? How can you help me? What is this?
My profession is knowledge. And I'm gonna give you information.
that only you can know. Now, no more questions, just answers. Are you ready?
Yes.
I am ready.
Good. Now let's go.
Bye.
I know that guy.
You do, but that's not the one from your world.
My world?
Yes, your world. There are many different versions of your timeline. Let me show you.
Yeah, that's me, but I don't remember this.
You couldn't. This hasn't happened for you yet. We're in a different timeline.
Different timeline? Like the future? Different timeline? What do you mean?
Not quite. It hasn't happened yet in this future timeline. What happened in the timeline in the past?
So, like, time travel?
Well, sorta. Here it uses space and time to pinpoint an exact moment. Space referring to the timeline that we're currently in. This future timeline is different from the one we were just in the past.
So I don't get it. I go to the past. My future self goes to the past in a completely different timeline from the one I'm currently in. And why is the milkman there? I just don't get it.
You see, Jim, in every timeline, there are different avatars of each character. In this timeline, that isn't the milkman you know. In this timeline, his name is Alex.
So, what about me? Where's my doppelganger? If that's me in that timeline, where's the original version of me in that timeline?
Dead. By many years at this point.
So why are you telling me this?
Let me show you. Because in this timeline, you're sent to the future by another version of yourself to stop Oliver from winning.
Oliver? You mean Detective Hood?
Maybe in your timeline, but not this one. His winning causes an unbalance in the space and time, allowing evil to grab hold of the multiverse. Simply put, this world is a melting pot of cosmic energy that's capable of changing the tide of the future. And the Russians in the timeline know it. And if Oliver had won the Battle Royale in that timeline, it would allow the Russians to pursue their research beyond just their world and share it with others, communicating through time, allowing the Milkman timeline to happen in your world. And many other bad things to happen in other worlds.
I thought Detective Hood was good.
He is, Jim. The Russians recognized his cosmic connection to the other worlds and staged the whole war zone to make him win. Oliver had no clue how powerful he was in that timeline. Jim, I can only look at space and time, give guidance to the others, tell them what to do next. I can't manipulate this space and time. I just know everything. That is where you come in.
Why me? If there are so many different versions of me, so many different worlds, why me?
You're the most connected to the cosmic energy. It'd be the version of you from this world. But you don't exist. And you're the next in line. You need to stop what is coming in your world. Because you already failed in the future by trying to prevent this from happening. You now must stop it in its tracks.
So what exactly am I stopping then?
As you know, the Russians are in on this milkman thing. Back during the Cold War, during the arms race, a certain dairy-related serum was created. However, a certain compound in the serum was very rare, so only one was made, creating the milkman we know now. He was once a normal person. He was a prisoner of war. He was like you, Jim.
So, the Russians are behind all of this? And that's why the milkman hid all that stuff around the world, even in our own town. I mean, and that must have been why the Russians were contracting out criminals to find it.
Yes. Your republic is at risk. democracy is at risk. They're planning on creating a whole Milkman army. Nuclear domination. And the man who created him is behind all of it. Many aspects of him are still human, and no one can take that away from him. But he's changed.
I didn't realize how deep this went. I don't know when it's the right time, but I'm making the right choices, doing the right thing.
The past can be manipulated. That can change the course of time. Many different outcomes can come from this change. And the future is not knowable. Only relevant based off of the decisions you make now. I hold the power to see what the future can hold. And in many of those cases, the world loses. Everyone loses. You can't keep it personal. And you have to realize that the lives of many outweigh the lives of a few. And you have to keep that idea in mind through this journey.
You have to tell me what happens if I stop this.
I can't, because if I do, it won't happen. All the pieces are in place. Now it's up to you to do what your past self couldn't do, and save us all.
How do I know when I'm supposed to make the choice that will change everything?
This. This is an ancient cosmic artifact. You can summon it at important cosmic shifts. I know you'll use it at the right time. It's up to you.
I didn't know. Nobody knew. Go say to the detective.
Secure the perimeter.
I know you're here, Daniel. You can't hide from me. I know what you've done.
Do they know what you did? Do they know who you are?
I haven't done anything. My men know that just as you do.
Then why are you here? What did I do?
You're involved with manipulation of evidence at a federal crime scene. You also have a federal agent held captive right now.
Your word is false. I wasn't a part of that.
Then why are you running, Daniel?
Then why just send this one guy, huh? Why didn't you send your whole army?
You are in no position to ask the questions here. You come out now, or I'll send my guys in there to kill you immediately.
You guys hear that? The FBI director just lost his cool. He's threatening a victim of a faulty crime. There's more to this whole story than I thought. Come to the house where the fourth death happened.
Hey! What are you doing over here?
Oh, shit.
Put that camera away.
Oh, shit. Oh.
Get up.
Oh. Oh.
What the hell?
Well, shit. You're gonna have to kill him, too.
Don't kill him!
Why not, detective? He has been a pain in my ass just like you.
He didn't do anything. We can do a trade. I'll give you your man if you give me the reporter. Then we can talk about giving myself up.
What's stopping me from killing him now?
If you kill my man, I'll kill your man.
You have a deal. All right, I'll give you my guy.
You first.
Hey,
Open fire!
So, Frank, I don't know why they're firing, okay? They just want to kill us. Did you at least upload the video of the corrupt director?
Yeah. The protester should be here any minute.
God, that gives us time, okay? My friend Jim, he's going to come, he's going to help us out.
Jim? Time? We don't have time.
The FBI, they care about their reputation, right? They're not going to come in here and storm and, you know, kill us or whatever.
So you're saying we should have some time to escape?
Yeah, we just have to hold out for Jim.
Jesus. Okay.
I don't know much about what's going on up there. All I know is that director guy, he's working with the Russians.
Russians?
Yeah.
Why are they chasing after us? Why does the FBI want us dead?
Frank, I don't know. Just gotta hold out and see where this goes.
God, Jesus.
Oh. The people!
We
do not silence the people!
Stop! We are people of this country!
Stop silencing the people!
We need to be heard!
How big's the crowd?
It's getting pretty strong, sir. What should we do about the detective?
Send the squad around to the back. We can't have any of the people knowing.
Aye, sir.
Oh, I should have been nicer to Susan. 165 News, this has been Dover reporting for the last time. Should never done a blow off the hooker's ass.
Hey. Listen. They're not trying to kill you. They're trying to kill me, right? I'm just as scared as you are. I'm in the same boat as you. I haven't even seen the fucking milkman yet. I don't even know what's going on. But they're not gonna come in here.
Thanks, man.
Right. See you.
Yeah!
lawful assembly.
Phase 2 of Operation Fiery Horizon and the Republic.
Execute the crowd. Leave no survivors. Get the detective.
Alright. You get the detective. The detective, okay? Alright. I got the director.
At ease.
What are we doing, sir?
You guys go get the milkman. I'll handle Agent Jim and Detective Hood.
Yeah.
So, Jim, bet you weren't expecting all this.
What is that?
How can we trust you?
Jimmy, mutual friend.
You poured milk on me. How am I supposed to forget about that?
Milk good for bones. Give special traits like me.
I'm nothing like you, milkman.
Please follow me. Save.
That?
Yes, other milkman. Go and take care of him. Oh!
Very proud of yourself, right?
Yeah.
Those videos you uploaded, you outed the corruption of the establishment. That takes courage. As far as I'm concerned, you're part of the team. You're important, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. We're gonna kick some fucking Russian ass. We're gonna do this, okay?
Hell yeah, man.
You got this. Go.
Fuck communism.
Shoot me already.
No, I can't do that, Jim. You're too good of an agent.
God, why'd you have to let it come to this?
Come to this?
You did this! All of it.
No, I'm saving these people. They just don't know it yet. I'm the only chance they have.
This power that you have, it's weakened you. You have no clue what you're doing. You think it's right, but it's not. How could you do this?
There's no other choice. I'm sorry.
Hey, director! Let's finish this.
He's got a gun! Where are you? Come on, Daniel, let's finish this.
Whoa, hey. You're not gonna shoot me, are you?
Oh no, I'm seriously considering it.
Hey, look, man. I didn't mean it before when I said I was gonna kill you.
Stop. We all know who you are. Stop trying to weasel your way out of this one. You're a man thirsty for power.
I'm not. You don't have the guts. You don't have what it takes. Even if you were to shoot me, it wouldn't make a difference. The detective right here, he's knocked out cold. And even if you did shoot me, the Russians would be here to gun you down.
Oh yeah? There's nothing stopping me.
Well...
Thank you.
Say your final words, American.
Duh. You two, take this seriously.
Duh.
Every night, and when that moon gets so big and bright,
thanks.
Yeah.
You can't dance and stay up tight. It's
supernatural delight. Everybody was dancing in the moon.
Director, I want to make you a promise. I'm going to kill you. I'm going to take you down. I got the milkman with me now. There's nothing stopping me. You have something I want. You have the detective. I'm gonna get him back. So mark my words, Director. I'm gonna kill you. And I'm gonna make it hurt. So you better watch out, because I'm coming and I'm not stopping until I get you. Let God be my witness. I will. Kill you. I will kill you.
I didn't want to do this, Daniel. But you, you're such a pain in my ass. I see it in you, Daniel. You want to kill me. We're supposed to be enemies. Oh, come on, Daniel. Say something. I'm the bad guy here!
Bullshit. You serve a master. Am I wrong? Goddamn psychopath.
I serve no one.
You serve your master. You shot into an entire crowd of people for the pleasure of someone else.
Shut it! We all have things to do. I'm trying to save the people. They're being led down the wrong path. He's in a part of the bigger picture. I'm the bigger picture!
Save the people? There's no one left to save after you're gonna kill all of them in your shitty fucking crusade.
Get him out of here! Teach him a lesson! You will be taught a lesson, Daniel, and you will know the power I hold. The power to control a great army of super soldiers, to squash the oppression in our society, and to command a new world order. And you will know pain!
He needs you. He needs your blood. It's all part of the bigger picture. You're just a tool.
This is a good piss, comrade.
Yeah.
Okay, alright, so I saw men in every building, basically, and in the town center around that tower area, most of the people, the soldiers are there. That's what I saw on my scout. What did you see?
Right side, he's gone. I go down.
Alright. Right side. So how are you gonna get in?
I distract.
So you distract, I go in playing soldier. I find the detective, and when the time is right, you make the distraction. And that allows me to get out with him, get to the rendezvous point where my guns are, and then all of us get out of here alive.
Agreed.
Alright. Alright, look. I'll see you on the other side.
Yes. I do not recognize you. Have you been to this outpost before?
No, no, actually.
Be on your way. Okay?
Yes, comrade. Later, comrade.
You're special.
How so?
Your blood contains a good amount of MK.
Isn't that shit you guys are pumping in those milkmen out there?
What you have is the unrefined version of it, the raw elements of it. It's such a shame you've been burdened with these powers, and you don't have the capabilities to use them. You're too weak.
And what makes you so strong?
I have more power.
You're missing the bigger picture here. You've been blindsided by this lust for power. That makes you weak.
What's wrong with knowing you're right? Knowing you're winning? Knowing you have the advantage? What do you even know about winning or being right at all? You couldn't even save those people who were killed by the milkman a year ago. You couldn't even save those protesters. You couldn't even save Mr. Dover.
Sick son of a bitch. No prophet. No crusader.
It's over, Daniel. I'm sorry.
Comrade, I have not seen you here before. Are you new?
Yes, comrade, I am. Move to inventory, just a sign, actually.
Comrade Belikov, do we have a new quartermaster in inventory?
Yes, comrade, he should have just gone back from the Choskit.
Oh, that is a huge relief. This will be huge.
Sorry, comrade. There's been some miscommunication tonight with all the activity going on. Comrade, the Red Crew has been securing the east side of the base and has our resources spread thinly.
No apologies necessary. Thank you for the update. All right. Well, comrade...
Nikolai!
Oh, comrade Nikolai. Well, your task will be to take inventory of the weapons. There should be 22 in total. I want their serial numbers written down.
Let's come back. We'll do it now. Guns here? You said that 22, but I only see 21.
21? Should go report this to Comrade Belikov. He'll be on the second building on the left.
Thank you, comrade.
Yes, comrade.
What's wrong?
Comrade Director, we have the surrounding area secure and are ready for any American incursion. We have troops deployed across every major American city. The sergeant's plan is working.
Not his plan. My plan. His time is over. Sergeant Igor no longer runs this operation. This is my plan, my new order. Now go gather the men. I have a proclamation to make.
Yes, comrade, sir.
What's happening to me? I've taken about 32 ounces of your blood, Daniel, to make something magnificent, enough to almost leave you dead. I'm gonna kill you. I'm gonna kill you. Oh, no, no, no. You can't die yet. I still have plans for you. I have to go and show them my power, prove my strength.
Well, this is all over. Go see how weak you really are.
You win today! Show them to the men!
Nothing. Comrade, I was just lost, I think.
What are your orders, comrade?
I just came from Captain Belikov's before that inventory. It is classified.
What are your orders?
Missing weapons. I was told to go to the tower and then find them there.
I will take you.
Today, we write a new chapter in our history books. Today is the day the Red Empire will rise as my empire. This is my operation now. Your leader, Sergeant Igor, if he truly cared about you, he'd be here fighting next to you right here. He'd be fighting this battle with you. But instead,
he sits alone in his ivory castle in the motherland. Yeah! On this eve, we bear to witness a new world order. I now take full responsibility as supreme commander of this empire. Sergeant Igor's time is now over. Yeah! And this specimen right here, the sergeant's most prized possession, is the key to a powerful army. Yeah! And this power right here gives me the power to resurrect the Red Army, to destroy the corrupt government system in place, to succeed where our Sergeant Igor could not. We will bring peace to the people, united as one. Yeah! We are now deployed in every major city in the United States. And this piece of scum right here tried to stop us. But he couldn't. We will always prevail. And he will always be a failure. Yeah! And the land you have conquered with your fellow comrades will now bring an end to the U.S. military and the U.S. government. And every remaining person will bow down to the Red Army and remember this as the last day of the United States.
Supreme Commander! 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 Supreme Commander!
Goodbye.
You all go investigate that now!
Gun down, Jim. Now please, kick the gun over here. Well, Jim, I'm surprised you made it this far. I assume that music is yours. quite clever, but not clever enough.
What did you do to him?
Oh, him? I gave him a purpose. He has far exceeded his use.
What happened to you? You were supposed to be the good guy. How could this happen? What happened to the greater good?
My purpose has become so much greater now. I have the responsibility to take the world as mine. Ours.
Ours? What the hell are you talking about?
Look around you, Jim. Your distraction won't last forever, and your friend is dying. You're a great warrior, a determined man, and when the odds are stacked against you, you still fight. Why is that?
I have a long list of reasons, and a couple against you.
Is that because of my insurrection?
No. No, its implications are far greater than you realize.
So you know.
No. No what?
His plan is upon us. We're only pawns in this game. You know who the real enemy is.
Real enemy? The real enemy? That's you! You're the real enemy! Hundreds of people, innocent people, have died! And your stupid, pointless mission. What are you doing? Why do you need him dead? What's the, why is it so important to you?
He's just too powerful to be kept alive. You just can't see his potential for greatness. You're blinded by your morals.
What are you talking about? Is that why you drained his blood?
Didn't you hear? His blood has the power to create a whole resurrected army. He is what some would call the chosen one. But you, you have the potential to be so great, so powerful. If you could just see past your goddamn morals.
Embrace the chaos, embrace your anger.
Join me. We can take down the sergeant together. I'm not sure I can do it alone.
Stay back, or else I shoot him. I swear to God, I'll do it.
Listen to what he says. Listen to him.
I'll blow his brains out.
No, no.
This little precious item of yours, it's done. Gone for everything you've worked for.
No, no, you can't do that.
I swear to God, I'll throw this thing over the edge.
Okay?
Yeah.
Come on. Come on. Come on.
You're all right.
Yeah. What's going on? What's the fucking director talking about?
Yeah. All in due time, right? I'll fill you in later.
Right.
Okay. Patience.
Yeah.
Oh, hello, dude. Come on. Oh.
Looks like you got kind of messy. All right, listen up. I'm gonna get Detective Hood out of here. He's not doing too hot, all right? He's just lost a lot of blood. Now you can take care of the dark one, but I'll take care of these men out there. I'll make a way towards the woods and if you need any help, I'll try to cover you best I can. This is it, this is the end game. Here we are. You can fight?
Of course.
All right. I'll see you on the other side again. Ready? Let's do this. Come on.
You guys take care of the milkman. I'll take care of Agent Jim and the detective. Go now! We gotta get out of here, get to the woods now, come on!
You need to hold on, Daniel.
No. I don't think I'm gonna make it.
Oh, come on, no. No. Look, I need you. I don't know where the milkman is. I need your help.
You were always better. The milkman didn't choose me. He chose.
James Darby, you think you would have been the...
Why are you laughing? Why?
Because you lost. I didn't have to kill the detective. I just did it to get back at you. And it worked.
No. Why'd you stop? Why would you? Why did you stop?
Finish this. I'm supposed to finish this. I killed your best friend. I killed your best friend. I killed the detective.
Destroyed me. You took everything from me. You ruined everything. All my hard work. It's all your fault.
No, you're mistaken. This is on you. Everything that has happened is on you.
How did I let the likes of someone like you beat me and destroy everything I built? You did this to yourself. I wouldn't kill you out of spite. I wouldn't do what you tried to make me to do, because that's not me. I wouldn't play your little game. You see, you are like me. You just don't know it yet. All it takes is just one bad day. I won't kill you out of spite. I won't kill you in cold blood. Well, I guess I'll make you kill me.
Time. What?
A pauper, a pirate, a poet.
a pawn and a king. I've been up and down and over and out, and I know one thing. Each time I find myself flat on my face, I pick myself up and get back in the race. That's life.
That's life.
I tell you, I can't deny it. I thought of quitting, baby, but my heart just ain't gonna buy it. And if I didn't think it was worth one single try, I'd jump right on a big bird.
You're to be judged in front of me, the one who knows all.
What am I being judged for?
You disrupted the timeline.
I did? I disrupted the timeline?
Yes. You invented the question mark.
The question mark?
You even almost caused World War III.
Oh, I know I did that.
And worst of all, you went to Applebee's.
Oh.
You left a bad tip.
Oh, that $1 wasn't big enough?
And your punishment, you'll be banished to Detroit.
Detroit? Please, no, not Detroit. Oh.
Now, Butch and Godfrey Cool Guy, I need you to bring him to Detroit, and when you're done, go to Sanibel. There's another timeline disturbance caused by Ricardo Torrens. Take care of it.
Yes, sir.
I've been a puppet, a pauper, a pirate, a poet, a pawn and a king. I've been up and down and over and out, and I know one thing. Each time I find myself laying flat on my face, I just pick myself up and get back in the race. That's life.
Order. I now take full responsibility as the supreme commander of this empire. Commander Igor's time is over to end our reign, but he will always fail. He is nothing but a failure.
He will always fail.
Excuse me.
This is a good piece.
Jeremy was like, stop making fun of my accent. I'm tired of it.
I'm trying.
All you gotta say is.
It's so hard to keep it together when you do that. It's a lot.
Is my accent that bad?
It's not that. It's I don't know.
You don't even know. I like.
2-1 action.
Jeremy, he starts giggling right when you say action.
Is he kind of? He's having a stomach piece.
Yo, why are you sniffing me?
I got that.
We're in a different. Come on.
A different. Come on.
A different timeline, Will. We're in a different timeline, Will.
Why would I do that? And why is Alex Milkman? Why is the Milkman there?
How do you know his name is Alex?
I didn't know that. I wasn't supposed
to. An exact moment in the space and time. Space referring to the exact moment in time we are in the space and time.
We're gonna have to redo that.
Here to speak about is the director of the FBI, Dr. Mai Shlong Long. It's the director of the FBI, or my close friend, Peter Hawk.
Thank you, Ben. Obviously we're...
One action.
This is how you do this thing. Oh, we're live? Good evening, folks. I'm Ben Dover with 1156 News. So, like, that's how you creep walk. Oh, we're live? Good evening, folks. I'm Ben Dover with 1156 News. Just the other night here, an FBI agent went missing alongside this road. The FBI is taking over the case, and here to talk more on the matter is the... The FBI director.
Do we have to have him dancing in this?
What a shame this is, to see such a valiant warrior dead on the ground. So pitiful. Such a great asset gone in the wind, huh? A shame. The motherland will weep in your death. But I see, still in death, you caused great pain to our enemies. The blood stains the canvas of the trees. The detective seems to have been dead. I wonder where his body is now. It doesn't matter. What matters is that you're not over, comrade. I'm not finished with you yet. Soon, there will be a new Eve. Your part is not over. Be seeing you soon.